हेलो मैम।
हेलो मैम। हाय हाय उदिता,
हाय मैम, हाउ आर यू दिस इवनिंग?
एम गुड उदिता, हाउ आर यू डूइंग?
आई एम आल्सो गुड मैम, बट आई हैड सर्टेन डाउट, सो आई थॉट ऑफ क्लेरिफाइंग दीज विद यू।
या
सो मैम,
श्योर
आई हैव बीन हियरिंग अबाउट सलाइवा ऑफ लेट फ्रॉम यू, एंड रिसेंटली आई केम अक्रॉस दिस अपकमिंग कोर्स ऑन सलाइवा टेक्नोलॉजीज। सो मैम, कैन यू प्लीज ब्रीफ मी अबाउट व्हाट दिस कोर्स इज ऑल अबाउट?
Sure. Actually, the course that is upcoming in August 14th, basically my idea is that to give you a basic track in a tool from a basic to an intermediate level of knowledge. So basically it will cover all the aspects right from basics still to the advanced technologies and other other things which are related to this particular field. And it's a very interdisciplinary field that I must say. So just to give a hang of the entire thing in one place, this course will be very much apt for the thing. So in two, three lines, I can tell you that it is a refresher course that will give you a overall idea as well as in-depth knowledge from a basic to a intermediate level of understanding. Related to the field of saliva diagnostics as well as genomic technologies, which will definitely come when we talk about saliva. Yeah.
Okay, so ma'am, who all can attend this program?
Udita, actually, this is a very, very open forum kind of a program because all my programs are like that. Because as you know, I believe in interdisciplinary. I promote interdisciplinary platform. So in that way, this is open to anyone who is enthusiastic in science. But let me just specify, it is open to anyone from the basic sciences field. Particularly, it would be good if it is from biological sciences, biomedical engineering, as well as it is open to anyone from the dental and medical fraternity. It is open to undergraduate students, interns, postgraduates, PhD students, faculties, and as I said, any science enthusiast, anybody can join this. So it's a very open forum kind of a program, actually. Yeah.
Now it's really good to know that you are collaborating. Everyone is invited to join this. But ma'am, at the same time, I'm confused. Since ma'am, this is a very versatile audience, so how a single program can cater to the needs of everyone?
I think, Udita, that's a good question that you asked. Maybe I will try to explain that. Like, for example, if an undergraduate student is coming, first of all, let me just put it like this, that this area of knowledge, it is not so very popular. But, you know, when it comes to dental people or, you know, our fraternity, as well as basic sciences, this is like it's for everybody. And particularly one tagline which I would like to mention for my dental friends, that is, most of the time we hate saliva, but if dentists start looking saliva not as a foe but as a friend and rather as a sample, then I think the revolution in science will happen very fast. It will progress very fast. So just coming back to answer your question, like, for example, for undergraduate students and interns, they will get an overview and overall understanding definitely of the science behind this. But apart from that, for them, it is very important to understand that where and how they can apply this knowledge. Well, this will obviously give them a boost to it will add on to their, credentials so that they can pursue different kind of relevant courses in the future. Like if they're trying to go for some postgraduate courses or somebody from the dental field who is interested to go into typically research field, like if they want to go abroad or maybe even in India, they want to take up courses like oral biology or something like that. So it will definitely add a boost to their knowledge towards the career. Secondly, if I talk about postgraduate students and PhDs, as I'm sure you being a faculty, you are much well aware of that, particularly the department you belong, oral medicine, then periodontology, Then I think oral pathology, and I think in every field of dentistry there is application. So in that way they will get the entire insight about how the biomarkers, what are the salivary biomarkers, how this can be used in different scenarios. And not I must not leave any other branches of dentistry, even like in pediatric dentistry there are many challenges, and also orthodontics, like you can analyze biomarkers, salivary biomarkers there. So it's kind of a very versatile thing, so they will get an overall understanding of the technological aspects, and then also the decision making. Like for example, most of the time what we do that we come up with some project ideas, and then we have to outsource the work to somebody else who is expert in the technology. So in this process what happens, there is a problem, because as clinicians we are not so aware of where to go and you know what to choose and what not to choose. So I think that demarcation, see, we don't have to become an expert in technology, that's not required, but at least we should have that knowledge so that we can make, you know, we can gain the discretionary power and we can choose which is best, and what to choose we should know that. So this kind of information would be there. And definitely for faculties, like as you are a faculty and you encourage your postgraduate students for projects, and you encourage your UG students also for the project. So you will also understand, that is for anybody, I must say, it's not only for specifically for faculties, but this area would be more beneficial for the faculties. Like in this course, I'll also put how you can design your own saliva study, whether you have an idea or you don't have any idea, if it's zero from scratch, how can you build it up? Also, I'll give you insights regarding the budgeting of a project, because I think when it comes to faculties and also as well as students, that is one thing which everybody is concerned of, about the funds, the budgeting. So all these things will be covered. And one single thing I will also, two other things I want to add on to your to answer your question is that I also, in all my programs, I also tell something something called as bio entrepreneurship, because saliva is something with which you can actually plunge into bioentrepreneurship. Let me just make it very simple. If we are not understanding what is bioentrepreneurship, basically we can translate research into clinics, and with saliva it's very exciting field and we are not much exposed to. So when once you get, you know, exposed to this field and you know how wonderful it is, you will be fascinated to know. And third, another thing definitely I would like to tell you is that even clinicians who are particularly who are into medical and dental field, there are many aspects, many genomic technologies that are available. Well, you might then ask me, okay, ma'am, is it in India or we have to think something for the, I mean, on the basis of Western countries. But Vita, I will just tell you that it, you know, for the past, I think 5-6 years now, it has been a genomic boom in India. So there are many technologies where particularly I will tell about the dental fraternity, because medical fraternity has already started taking advantage of these things. So for the dental fraternity, you know, as a clinician, suppose you are a private practitioner, you just don't have to do anything. You just have to convince your patient, and definitely you need to know how to, you know, which case to select. Everywhere you will not go and tell about these things to all patients. Then there are certain genetic tests that is for the good of your patient. You can very much refer, but yes, you need to know whom to tell, what is the case selection, and what you have to do. You actually, as a clinician, you don't have to do anything. You just need to understand the science behind it, and you need to convince your patient. You have to give the proper information, and the entire the analysis part is taken care of. It's a very, very formatted, versatile way of working. It works wonderfully. I can tell you that you just collect saliva and send it to the lab. If that much is your work. So, and in that way, as a private practitioner, by taking up these new things, you can actually make your profile very rich compared to the others. It will be different. It will give you uniqueness. It adds to your USP, and as well as you are providing a very holistic service to your patient. That is most important for a clinician. So I think that was overall answer which I could give you. I hope I could answer your question, what you asked. I think Udita, you have to unmute yourself.
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am, I was just saying this only that you have not only answered, but ma'am, your insights, they have ignited new ideas in my brain. So, ma'am, out of my keen interest in forensic odontology, I just want to ask how the knowledge of the saliva technologies will help me. Like you said, here you'll be teaching about how to plan a new study. So, ma'am, can you in brief tell me how this is going to help me?
I'll share it with you. Urita, when it comes to forensics, basically, saliva, if I tell saliva as a sample instead of sample, I can tell it's a specimen, because suppose when it comes to forensics, we generally don't get the saliva as a you know, in the form of a solution. It might be dried, or you know, it might be in some scratch form, or maybe it might be invisible because it might be, you know, in the some clothes or maybe some other surfaces where we actually even don't know. And in the way of investigation, we might try, you know, tend to tamper it. So there are certain technologies with which very easily you can identify, even if the saliva is invisible, it is dry, you can identify that. And I mean, you will be able to know whether saliva was present there or not. It can be from a cloth or from wood surface or any other surface, because in forensics, that is the one thing you have to retrieve your specimen. And then coming to the analysis part, yes, there are certain genomic and genetic technologies which are very much applied. And like that is for any sample in forensics, whether you are getting a tooth, you are taking a tooth, taking up a tooth, or you are taking a dried blood sample or saliva sample, then might be you first jump into getting the DNA out of it. So that's a very universal protocol, and all these kind of technologies pertaining to different areas will be covered in this particular course. So definitely, if not everything, but something of forensics will definitely be there. And I think I missed one point while answering your question previously. With this also, as you say that you want to do a study, maybe you want to plan your study. So in one of the modules, the entire module is dedicated as a mini project work. So you will learn, the participant will actually learn how to build up a project, or how to put their thoughts into practicality, in which areas what they have to think, what technology they should use. So all these things will be it will be a mini project. So that way it is planned. Yeah.
Wow, ma'am, that's really an eye opener for me. And ma'am, recently, ma'am, one of my friends, she is into pediatrics. So, ma'am, she is doing a study. So, ma'am, this study, it includes all pediatric patients. And, ma'am, these are syndromic patients, and they are medically compromised, and they have to collect samples out of this. So, ma'am, this friend of mine, she was telling that it is very difficult to retrieve these samples because of this population they are working on. So, ma'am, like you said, that if we have any research idea or if we have any project, so, ma'am, if such people who are facing similar difficulties, so ma'am, can you please brief how knowing about these saliva technologies can help them at least in a better fashion, so that they can collect saliva and then they can proceed? Because right now they are stuck at the first step itself.
Right, Udita, that's a very good thing that you shared, the incident you shared about your friend. Well, when it comes to child patients or medically challenged patients, yes, it is difficult because their compliance is not as compared to the normal people. So when it comes to saliva, actually in this course, I will also give you an insight, a very detailed insight of different types of advanced saliva collection tools. So by using these, you know, it will become very easy for the researcher or the, you know, the faculty, whoever is doing the particular study, the researcher, it will be very easy for sample collection, because I'll tell you, now with technology, we are so advanced in biology that we have saliva collection devices for right from a neonate to a child. You know, if it's a child patient or medically compromised, well, there are protocols which definitely you have to follow when you are talking about, or we are working with medically challenged people. All these aspects in nutshell, or in every aspect, these things, what precautions you will take, where you can go wrong, what are the challenges that you might face when you start working with saliva, and how to troubleshoot them. So these would be the most important areas that would be really focused on. And as you asked me about dentistry and you asked me about forensics, so all this knowledge will again be related to different branches, so that everybody who is coming in can relate it very well, and they can take with the takeaway message, they can actually implement. Yeah.
Wow, ma'am, that's really nice to know that you're not only teaching the theoretical aspect, but you are teaching us how to troubleshoot the problems. This is very helpful, ma'am, because anyone can start a study, but the real problem arises when we get stuck at some point. And that's very helpful of you that you are teaching this also, how to outsource, what are the tips that should be kept in mind when you're outsourcing a project, because everything cannot be taken care of as ourselves. So it is very important to know whom to approach, how to approach. And this is a really very nice idea to include case studies and to incorporate real research ideas into the program. This is really nice. But ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am. Like you said, and I have read also that this is an online program. Everywhere it's mentioned this is an online certification program. So ma'am, how do I get a practical hands-on approach if I register, or if someone registers for this course, how they get a practical hands-on feel after attending this course?
I think that's a very good question you asked, Rita. See, basically the thing is here, what I'm trying to do is, here I will not teach you something which is written in the textbook. Here, whatever I will tell you is about how you put that theory into practical application. Let me just give you one example. As I said, that there will be a mini project. So in that mini project, you will literally, you have to brainstorm, you have to literally come up with, if you have an idea, then it's very good. If you don't have an idea, then you have to brainstorm. And we will actually, if there is, say, whatever participants are there or whoever is registering, we will work one-to-one. It will be like a one-to-one interaction, because as you know, maybe if you go to the website for more details, if you are interested, or if any of your colleagues are interested, if you just go to our website, that is www.jeanden.com, and we have a tab called courses. You just click there and you will find this more details about saliva technologies. You will see that it is mentioned that it is kind of a overall idea, overall refresher course. So the main thing here is that when you ask me that how I give you the practical ideas, this is entirely based on practical, because when I'm telling you about the mini project, even if you are not doing, say, I tell, okay, I'm teaching you PCR from polymerase chain reaction, how you will do it from saliva sample, taking out the DNA, you might not do it with your, you know, with touching the instruments. The only difference is you are not touching the instruments, but I will make you to do it on a pen and paper. So it's very innovative. It's a very innovative thing. So on the pen and paper, we can do many things. And basic thing is to understand, because whenever we short training courses, even when I used to do it offline in my lab and all. So what happens if you haven't come, I cannot teach you molecular biology in 2 months. That is not possible. So the main idea was that you would come around, see around, and you will be observer mostly. Unless you do it with your own hands. But I think to the point of healthcare professionals or even other basic sciences researchers, it is always not necessary that you have to do the technology, but you should know in and out about the technology. You should know where you can go wrong, because if you know where you can go wrong, then only you will solve the problem very easily. Whomever you are hiring or whomever you are outsourcing, it becomes very easy for you to troubleshoot those problems, because all the time it is not very interesting to depend on, you know, on someone, on the third party or someone else. And another important point I will just tell and wind up, sometimes suppose you have given your sample and that sample is not, as you said about your friend, suppose every time they won't get that patient will not be compliant always. So when they, right, so when they get the sample, that is like a very precious treasure. So so that sample cannot be wasted. So what happens, whenever you have outsourced your work, whether they are doing it correctly or not, there are very certain tricks, there are very certain tips, certain statistical tips with which you can just find out. For that, you don't have to be a biostatistician. You don't have to know what is statistics. But just by seeing those things, you will be able to understand. You will be actually so pinpointedly, you can find out that you can actually catch hold whether the technician went wrong and whether the sampling was wrong, whether the dilution was wrong. So that's fascinating. So all these kind of things which you really face in the practical life, and I mean when you do the work, so all these things will be actually spoken of into this particular course. In one line, I can say that if someone attends this, if they don't know anything about saliva or saliva diagnostics or technologies or whatever, when they go out of this course, they will be confident enough to at least think or start something on their own. So that much I can tell you. And if someone is really boosted, particularly the healthcare professionals as well as basic sciences people, they can think of bioentrepreneurship. That's a fantastic thing where you can come up with your own, research and develop your own product, which might have commercial impact and social impact. So that will be covered. That is there in of my course, obviously, whichever I do. Yeah.
Ma'am, that's really nice to know, ma'am. This one course is offering us so many things. It's really, as you said, it's starting from the basic level and going till the advanced level. What else can be expected, ma'am? Ma'am, really, ma'am, thanks a lot for sharing these valuable insights with me. Really helpful.
Thank you, Udita, for your question. Today I was a little nervous that what Udita will ask me, because when I told you about the course, he was like, you had many question marks, and then you said, ma'am, can we discuss this? So I think your idea was great. I think discussion of ours will help others also to relate. Yeah, so it was fantastic talking with you.
Yeah, ma'am, it's very natural for us because, ma'am, though we have been dealing with saliva, but as you mentioned, we have always been considering saliva as a foe. We have always been isolating ourselves from saliva. And this is the first time when we are listening at how beneficial it could be. It has really been of immense help. So, ma'am, the website is www.genedent.com.
Okay, Udita, so I think we will just take your leave, and I think I could answer all your questions. Take care and stay safe.
You too, ma'am. Good night, ma'am.
Thank you. Good night. Thank you, everybody, for joining us, and thank you for being here as always. So I hope this conversation helped you a lot. Thank you so much.